गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई थिंक एवरीबडी इज रिवाइजिंग द टॉपिक एंड एट द सेम टाइम पेइंग अटेंशन इन योर स्टडीज, मेकिंग नोट्स, क्लियरिंग योर डाउट्स एंड वाट एवर प्रॉब्लम यू आर फेसिंग यू आर नोटिंग इन डाउन एंड राइटिंग द होमवर्क ऑल्सो इन योर कॉपी. सो टूडे अगेन आई एम हियर विद द टॉपिक दैट इज़ अ क्रिएटिंग अ डेटा फ्रेम, बिकॉज the topic we are not finished in the last video, and so I want to continue with the same, that is the creating a data frame. So we had discussed in the last video to create the data frame using these two points, that is the two, using the two dimensional dictionary or using the two dimensional NDRA. In the first point, I want to recall you that what we had done in the ways for creating the data frame. In the first point, as we had created the database from 2D dictionary having values as list or NDRA, that means we had created a data frame with the dictionaries where the dictionaries values were the list or the NDRAs. And in the first point itself, we have created the data frame from 2D dictionary, but this time the dictionary's values were the dictionary object itself. What? The dictionary's value will be the dictionary's object itself. So we had discussed two points under this first way, that means two-dimensional dictionary where the data frame has created. The second way was two-dimensional NDRA, that means we had created the data frame object from a list of dictionaries or list of dictionaries or the list itself. Okay, in the second ways where we had created the data frame object using the NDRAs, that means the using the NumPy array. Now we will create we will see first how to create the data frame using the series type of object, and afterwards we will create the data frame object using data frame itself. So this I will want to continue with the same topic, that is the creating a data frame. So let us start with the point, that is how to create the data frame using series type of object. So creating a data frame object from 2D dictionary with values as a series object. Okay, so just see here that data frame object can be created using multiple series object, not only the single series, but you can create multiple series, and the 2D dictionary can have the values part as the series object. In the last point we had seen how 2D dictionary's values had differ for creating the data frame. In the first point we have seen the dictionary's value where the list or the NDRAs. In the second one we had seen the dictionary values with the list of the dictionaries or the list itself, and in this point where we are using the series object for creating the data frame where 2D dictionary values will be the series object. Okay, 2D dictionary we are using, but the 2D dictionary's values will be the series object. And how many series object? Multiple series you can create it. So it means that first of all we will create the series object, then we will use the series object as a value for the dictionary. So first you will create the series object, then you will create the dictionary where the dictionary's value will be the series object, clear? And afterwards we will pass the dictionary as a argument of the data frame function. That means the last point actually is for creating the data frame. So two things, first of all you will create the series object or simply the series, then you will create the dictionary, and afterwards you will pass that very dictionary. And what will contain in the dictionary? The dictionary will contain the keys as well as the value and the value will be the series object. Okay, so we will see, when we will see in the example, then it will be more clear to us. So let us move to the example of this particular point. So first of all, you just see, first of all, I have written as a comment one the series object created. Two series I have created here. One is staff, another one is salary. In the staff, we have taken the value as 1534.42. You are already knowing how to create the series. Here we are creating the series with the function as series function, and the argument that we had passed here as a list value. 1534.42 is the item inside the list because it contains inside the square bracket. So staff is created with these three value, and salaries as the name of the another series object we are creating with this particular value. 245,000, 387,000, and afterwards 511,000. And after creating the series, we have created the school as a name of the dictionary. You can see here, so as a comment one it is written, dictionary stores this salary object as value, this salary object, this series object as value. What are the series objects? Staff and salary. And what are the values of the series object? This particular value 1534.48, and afterwards this one, that is 245,000, 387,000, and so on. So here we are after creating the series object, we are creating the dictionary, and the name of the dictionary here I have taken as school. So in the school dictionary, we have created two keys. One key is the people and another key is the amount. And under this very key, the first key, that is the people, the values is staff. And staff is what? Staff is the name of the series. So as we had seen, no, that the dictionary's value will be the series object. So here the series object is the value. You are already aware that dictionary contains the value in as a key and value pair. So key is people and value is staff, and itself is a series object. So I think it is clear to you. And the second key of this school is the amount. Amount is the key which stores the value as a salaries, and salary is what? Salary is the another series object. So we have created here the two series object. Whatever series object you want to create, you can create it, like staff, salaries, and if any required, then that also can be created. But you need to take care is that series object will be passed. Series object will be the values for the dictionary. Okay, so dictionary is school, people, amount, keys, staff, salaries, value, and this staff salary is the series. So first of all, you will create this very series, then you will create the dictionary. Afterwards, now this dictionary will pass as arguments to a data frame function. So this dictionary is school, you will pass as an argument. So here we have created the name DTFR as the name of the data frame, and using the data frame function, we are creating the data frame. And what value I have passed, or what value I have supplied for this very function, school. And school is what? The name of the dictionary. So I think step by step you have to move on. First of all, we will create the series, then after you will create the dictionary, and afterward the dictionary you will pass it as a argument for the data frame function. And this especially command is the command for creating the data frame. So I have explained this as here dictionary's keys, people and amount. This people and amount are the dictionary's key. Okay, so that will become the columns. Means when you will create the data frame, and when you will take the output of that very data frame, then you will see that the dictionary's keys. What is the dictionary's keys? People and amount, that will become as a column of the dictionary. That will become the column of the data frame, and the values contained in the series. This value 1534.42 and this particular value will be the series value, and that will become the rows of the data frame. Okay, so data frame column will be the dictionary's key, and the data frame rows will be the series value, because you are taking the dictionary's values as the series. So in this way, you will create the data frame using the series object. Series directly cannot be used for creating the data frame. First of all, you will create the series, then the series values, a series object will be the values for the dictionary. It means that you will create the series, you will create the dictionary. When you will be creating the dictionary, then keys or and values will be there, and the value of the keys of the dictionary will be the series object, and at last you will pass the dictionary as an argument for the data frame function. And when you will take the output for that, then the dictionary's keys will be the column of the data frame, and the rows of the data frame will be the series values. So that we will do it using the program. So first of all, we will go to the IDLE, and then we will see how, if we will write this very program, if we will write this very code, how it will appear in the output. So let us move to the IDLE. Yes, you can see here that we have now come in the IDLE, and the program, the script is written, the same coding that we had seen just now in our slides. You can see import pandas as pt. This is required because we are using the data frame as well as the series in this very program. So first of all, one print is given as the series object created. That means you don't get confused what is going on in the program. That is why in the output, when you will see, you can see how step by step, if the print statement you will be giving, the output will be more clear to you for understanding. So here one print series object created. Which series object? Staff and salaries. How you can recognize that this is the series? Because the pd.series is written. And 153442 is the name of the, is the value for the staff series. And salaries, the second one, we are creating as pd.series, and these were the salaries of, okay, 2,45,000, 3,87,000 and 511,000. Don't put the separator over here, as if you want to write 2,45,000, then you will write 2,45, if you will write in this way, then what will happen, the values will be, it will display the value of the salary will be, first of all the 2 will be the salary, then 45,000 will be the value, then 3 will be the value, then 87,000 will be the value. So it is recommended that don't use the separator for writing any values when you are writing any program. Okay, that is why I have used the separator in the slides, but I am not using the separator for this particular salary here in the program. So two series objects, staff salary, is created, and another print is given especially for the displaying of the staff and salaries explicitly. That means we want to display the staff as well as the salaries in the output. So what output is coming, what output will be coming? Series is staff, and then staff value, this one, this series will display. Afterwards, in the new line, series salaries, that means the this salaries value will be the output for this particular coding. So first of all, separately I have taken the output for the staff, that is the one series, and salaries, that is the second series object. Now you see the comment line, dictionary store this series object as a value. In the slide also you had seen that is school, where the name of the dictionary, where people and amount were the keys, and staff and salaries are the values for this very dictionary, that means the school dictionary. And later on, now that this dictionary will pass as the argument to data frame function, that means data frame object created by passing the dictionary named school. This will come as an output, and this is just for the understanding of the code. That means dictionary will pass, which dictionary? This is school, as an argument of data frame. So this is the coding DTFR, name of the dictionary pd.dataframe, and then the school, the name of the dictionary school you have passed as a argument for the data frame function. So this is the line, this is the script, this is the code which is used for creating the data frame. And here we have passed the dictionary, name of the dictionary school, okay, and this dictionary is already created. And afterwards we are taking the print out for the data frame. So here I have explained this very line, that dictionary's keys, that is the people and amount, this dictionary's key, which is the people and amount, will be the columns of the, will be the columns, okay, people and amount will become the column, and the values contained in the series, and the values contained in the series will become the rows of the data frame. That means, just I have explained this as a comment line so that you clear in your mind that when you will write this type of coding, what will be the column and what will be the rows of the data frame. Sometimes the questions may come that what will be the output. So you should clear in your mind when you will be taking the output for this very data frame, which is DTFR, and you have created the data frame with the help of series, then people and amount, which is the key of the dictionary, will become the column, and the values contained inside the series, which is the value which is contained inside the series, is this 15, 34, 42 and 2,45,000, 3,87,000 and 5,11,000. These are the values for these two series, and that will become the rows of data frame. So when you will execute this one, it will be more clear to you. You will be getting how many out print statement is given. First print will be coming as the series object creation, then series staff, then series salary, and last one, data frame object created by passing the dictionary, and finally you will see the output for the data frame. So let us execute with that. After executing, you can see series object created. This has come as an output because we have written the in the inside the print statement, and afterwards you will see the series staff and the series salary. Series staff, that means the staff as well as the salary separately will be coming, like series staff 15, 34, 42. This is the value. I have told you that when you will take the output for the series, two column will be coming. One is the index, another one is the data value. So this is the data value. This is by default index 012 is coming, and the data type int 64 is coming because of this very data value. Second series is the series salary. 2,45,000, 3,87,000, 5,11,000 is the data value. 012 again is the default index for the salaries series. And int 64, because the data type of this particular data value is int 64. Next print is given as data frame object created by passing the dictionary named school. That means data frame, when we are creating, then we will pass the dictionary as the argument for the data frame. And finally, the output which you are seeing over here, people amount 012, this one is actually the output for the data frame, output for the data frame. So in the last comment line, I had told you that the keys of the dictionary will become the column. Keys of the dictionary were people and amount, and the values of the series, first value were 15, series were the staff series, you can see here, first series were the staff and second series were the salary, and this value has come as an output of the data frame. So this 15, 2,45,000, these were the first value of the staff as well as the salaries series. the second 34 and 387,000 were the second values for again the staff as well as for the salaries, and third row which is 42 and 511,000. So this we has the where this is the value for the staff as well as the series, which value? The third value. So actually this 15, 34, 42, this all three values, this all three rows are the staff salaries value, sorry, staff series value, and this 2,45,000, 3,87,000 and 511,000 are the values for the second series, which is the salaries. So this will be the output when you will create the data frame with the help of series object. Series values will become the rows and dictionaries keys will become the column. So first step is you will create the series, second step you will create the dictionary, and third step you will pass the dictionary as the data frame object, data frame argument. Clear? So in this way you will create the data frame. Next we will see the another way for creating the data frame. Now the next way for creating the data frame is creating a data frame object from another data frame object. That means this data frame is created with the help of data frame itself. Okay, so we can pass an existing data frame object. That means you had created the data frame and now you want to create the data frame with the help of the earlier one, with the help of the existing one. Then we can use this particular coding. So we can pass an existing data frame, the data frame which we had created, we can pass as an argument of the data frame, and it will create the another data frame object having similar data. Similar data means the first data frame object you have created, and that only data frame object you are passing for creating the another data frame. Then what will be the new value is coming. So the value of the data frame will be, when you will take the output for that, then it will be the same value of the earlier created or existing data frame. So the coding or how you will use, just see the example here. ARR1, this I had told you in the last video, in when we had created the data frame with the help of 2D array, that only I had taken as an example. Array 1 we have created, ARR1 is the name of the array which contains the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that means the two rows and three column, and afterwards we are creating the data frame by passing this array. So first data frame is DTFR. Don't confuse, this DTFR is the existing data frame which we were talking about, that we can pass existing data frame object. So first of all, we had created the data frame object using this array. It doesn't mean that when you will create the data frame, it always will be the array. I have told you 4 to 5 ways. Any of the ways you can create the data frame according to the question what asked. Okay, so this particular data frame which we had created here is the with the help of the array. Okay, and afterwards the second DTFR2, that means that second data frame object DTFR2 I have created with the help of the existing data frame. This DTFR I have passed as an argument of this data frame function, and this DTFR is the argument which has already created, and this DTFR is already a data frame. So here we are creating the data frame with the data frame itself. That is, this DTFR is the data frame object which we had created with the help of array, and now another data frame object I am creating over here with the existing data frame. So what value DTFR will be having? The same value, the same output you will be getting for the DTFR2, as we will see in the program. So just move to the program and we will see the output for this very coding. You can see here the same script I have taken, which I have told just now in the slides. Import pandas and pd and import numpy as np. This import numpy we are using over here because we are creating first of all the array. So array 1 is created with the value 1 2 3 4 5 6 and the DTFR, the data frame, is creating with the help of this particular array. ARR I have passed as an argument of data frame. So one data frame DTFR I have taken separately the output so that you can see that the both data frame output is same or similar data will be there in the second data frame. So this is the DTFR output, which is the first data frame which I have created with the help of array, and the second data frame I am creating here as DTFR2, which contains the value, or you can say which this DTFR2 is the name of the another data frame, and this data frame value is passing as the data frame object. Data frame is the name of the function, and here we are passing what? DTFR, which is the existing data frame or already created data frame. So we are creating the data frame here with the help of another data frame object. So what value DTFR contains, the same value DTFR2 will be containing. So let us see the output. You can see here 0 1 2 0 1 1 2 3 and 4 5 6 1 2 3 and 4 5 6 is the value for the array. 1 2 3 4 5 6 is the value for the array, you can see, and this has print DTFR. This whole starting from here till here is the output for this DTFR. So 0 1 2 automatically, I have told you, when you will pass the array as an argument for the data frame, then its index will be 0 1 for the rows and 0 1 2 the default indexing for the column also. And this 0 1 2 and 0 1 1 2 3 4 5 6, this the second one output is for the DTFR2. So there is no any differences between the first data DTFR and the second data frame object which I have created just now as DTFR2 pd.dataframe DTFR. So this DTFR2 is the name of the data frame, second data frame object, and the output for this is this one. If it is not clear to you, just I am making here the one print so that the output you can differentiate it. Just I am changing here as the data frame created with existing data frame. Now you will understand the things in a proper way. Okay, and make a line and make a new line so that you don't have the means the clear output I want to see. Second output you need to pay attention. This one 012 column heading, 01 the row indexes, and here 1 2 3 4 5 6 is the value for the data frame. And just you can see data frame created with existing data frame, one print I have given. So this is the output for the DTFR2, which is the data frame object which I have created based upon the earlier one. So no changes in the data. So in this way you can create the data frame with the help of using the another data frame. Okay, so now we will see that how, when you will use the data frame function for creating the data frame, the thing that you need to know is you will have to see first of all that when you are creating the data frame with the help of series object, the series must be created first of all. Then afterwards you will create the dictionary, you will pass the dictionary's value as a not pass, you will take the dictionary value as the series object, and afterwards the dictionary will be passed as the data frame function. The second I have told just now how to create the data frame using the another data frame. And the last one which I want to tell you, which is not given in the Simita Arora book, is creating the empty data frame. Means if you want to create the empty data frame, then how it will be created. So let us move first of all the slides, how to create the data frame. So let us go to first of all in the slides, in the PowerPoint slides, how to create the empty data frame, and then we will come back in IDLE. Now you can see the last one. The last way for creating a data frame is creating empty data frame. Suppose you have a question that how to create the empty data frame, and later on if you want to put any value in the data frame, then how it will be done. To create an empty data frame, we use the following command. The command which is used, it is very simple. You have already created the empty array, you had created the empty series, now the empty data frame. So import pandas as pd, and the data frame name df I have used over here, and the command pd.dataframe, and this time no argument we are passing, neither dictionary nor array nor the series. So here what will happen in this very coding, that's what the empty data frame will be created. The data frame will be created, but this time no rows, no column will display. It will be empty, no value will contain in this very data frame. So here is a comment line I have written here is df is the name of the data frame, df or dtfr, whatever you are means using the data frame object name, it should be meaningful in the sense that you don't use a b c d or x y z. It is not actually the no problem will be there, syntax wise it is correct, but we use the meaningful name so that it will be feasible, or it will be easier to understand for anyone. Okay, so df is the name of the data frame, and the same coding if we will write how it will be written in IDLE, that we will see. You can see here that in IDLE I have written the command as import pandas as pd, and we are creating the empty data frame. Data frame name I have taken as df equal to pd dot data frame. I am again telling you that d and f of data frame must be written in capital letter. Okay, and this time this bracket is blank, means no value I have provided over here, no argument actually is passed here. It means the data frame will create, but it will be empty. So here print df I have taken as an output for the empty data frame. You will see that no rows, no column will be coming. So this is the way for creating the empty data frame. And now here you can see that I have written one more print if you want to know the type of the data frame. As we had seen how to see the type, how to find out the type of that series. So here also if you want to know the type of the data frame, you will use type function, and inside the argument of the type function you will write the data frame name, and here the data frame name is df. So one print for displaying the output for the empty data frame, another print to display the type of data frame will be coming as an output, and lastly the type will display of the data frame. So when you will execute, three output you will see. You can see empty data frame, columns, square bracket opening and closing, no value, index opening bracket closing bracket. Index means the rows of the data frame, and columns means the column itself. So this particular output, empty data frame, column and then empty one, and index square bracket opening and closing the empty one, will be coming as an output for this very print df. So when you will take the output for empty data frame, you will see three lines will be coming. One is for empty data frame, then columns and row. Don't write row here, because row name, row nomenclature you can see will not be coming or will not be used in the data frame. In place of row it will be index. Okay, row label it will be termed as index. Column is the column itself. So both columns as well as row will be empty. So when the output will be coming, or when you have to write the output for the empty data frame, you will see this very things in the empty data frame. And the type of data frame, this line is coming because of this very print command, the type of the data frame. What is the type of the data frame? The type of the data frame, when you will take type df, print type df means you are taking the type for the data frame. So this one, this line, class pandas dot core dot frame dot data frame, this will be coming as an output for the type of data frame. If you will take the type of integer, then it will be coming as int 64 or float 64 or float 32. So here when we will take the data frame output, when it is there, if you want to see the data type of data frame, then you can see this very output. So you have to by heart this one, class pandas.core frame dot data frame. And in the case of series, the output was same, except here in place of data frame it would be written as a series, data series. Okay, so this point I wanted to discuss you in today's video. I think everything is clear, and you will do at the same time in the system, you will write every programs in whatever I am showing you in ideally as well as the theoretical things, you will write in the copy whatever I am showing you through the slides. Clear? So I think you all are revising the topic, and it is very painful for me that when I will see the attendance for each days, you hardly means I will see the responses hardly 48, 46, 68, like that, means almost 100 students is there in IP, 12th IP, and 30%, 40% students are still not showing now, more than that. So I am making the attendance from 15th April till the date, and the same attendance I will forward to you based upon the views what I am getting in the campus care. And afterwards this attendance will go to the vice principal ma'am as well as the sir, and let us see what decision they are taking for that. So those is still those who, many of the students are not watching a single video. Just think about it, how painful it is for any of the teacher or for me. It is my request that you do watch the videos and note down the things whatever I am teaching, because when the school will open, I do not know when the school will reopen, but whenever the school will be open, the things whatever is taught will not be going to repeat, only the practical, maybe some practicals will be there, or some questions answer will be discussed to you. So you should be clear in your concept that this chapter is over, and whatever the topics are there, you just clear the concept of the topic. This I wanted to share with you. I think now you will pay more attention in your studies, and you will do the things according whatever the way the teachers are telling to you. So we will meet you in the next class, next video class, and I'll be giving you the homework based on the series, because the first topic of the chapter is series. So first of all, I will give you the assignment based on the series, and then I will give you the assignment based on the data frame. So you will start writing in your copying with the series. Okay. So let us wind up this video session, and we will meet you in the next class. Till then, take care. Goodbye.